Welcome to our Kanban University Distinguished Fellow Program. I'm Todd Little, Chairman of Kanban University, and today I have the privilege of introducing Sudipta Lahiri. So Sudipta, congratulations on being named a Kanban University Distinguished Fellow. Would you be able to tell us just a bit about yourself?
So, most people call me as Sudi. Most people know me as Sudi. It's been over three decades now in this industry, a long time. And I've done, you know, obviously, like any other person who's been there for a long time, I've done multiple things, right from core development to hardcore sales, including cold calling, and across multiple geographies. I would say for about, till about two-thirds of my career, we were all doing the regular waterfall way of software development, right? Till about 2000. I would say we were all completely into a waterfall model. Of course, the whole IT services industry where I grew up from, was its success was based on a very stage gate model. So that's what we were all very familiar with. In 2002, I first moved to product companies. My first exposure from IT service companies to product companies started. And even then, even in the product companies, it largely used to be in that way of working. So the industry was completely that way. I moved back to India early part of the last previous decade, and clearly in India we were beginning to see some early movements towards some of the extreme programming community itself. My own Agile journey started in 2010. At that point of time, our main product in Digiti used to be called Digiti Enterprise. And we started looking at, what kind of newer capabilities that we need to roll out into the product. That's how we first started looking at Agile capabilities, of course, to make it as an offering to our customers, and then quickly figure out that, hey, that is such an incredibly powerful way to do it that we also started to work that way. And since then, there really has been no looking back. From like three releases in a year, we now, have made tremendous improvement in terms of making release every 2 weeks. Our product quality has gone up 10x, which is pretty unbelievable. And looking back, it's pretty amazing how the entire industry has changed and evolved in the last three decades. One often thinks about all the new things in the technology front, right? Whether it's internet, mobile telephony, 5G, etc. But very rarely do we actually reflect back and think about how the industry has changed in terms of how we build software itself. And I think it's been a real exciting journey to be part of an industry that has really changed the way it has completely evolved itself.
Thank you. So you're telling us a bit of your story and how your overall journey was specifically to Kanban. Can you tell us how you were introduced to Kanban originally?
So, like I said before, we started looking at Agile in 2010. And when we first looked at it, it was pretty obvious for us that we were late as far as the Scrum market was concerned. There were quite a few players already in the Scrum market. I think Kanban was kind of picking up momentum at that point of time. And I think what really stood out for us was the simplicity of the Kanban method. Back then, I don't think it was still called the Kanban method specifically. I think it was just called Kanban in general. And so though our understanding was limited, we actually started working that way. Very soon fell in love with it. We actually built out a brand new product from scratch with a completely new architecture at that point of time. And that's how Swift Kanban got actually rolled out sometime in 2011, mid-2011. The outcome itself was pretty transformational for us. in terms of how we were able to make things really happen compared to how we were doing it in our other product, which still was called Digital Enterprise at that point of time. We reached out to David sometime in 2012 or 13. We participated in the Lean LSSC conference, Lean Software, Lean System Software Consortium. I think that's what it was called at that point of time. It was either 2012 or 2013. I don't remember which year exactly now. That's how we actually first started talking with David, and we talked about working closely with them. Over a period of time, the relationship grew stronger. We were really very, I would say, happy and fortunate to really work on the enterprise services planning module, with David, because it really was fairly complex in terms of the kind of data modeling, computational and visual design that it needed to bring forward to. It was absolutely several years ahead compared to anything that was out there in our space. So it's been over a decade now that we have been working with Kanban. Like many other product companies, of course, we have not just been selling the Swift Kanban product, but we also have been helping many of our customers in the Kanban journey itself. Training them, I won't say training in terms of a dedicated training program, but like assisted getting them understand the concept. Of course, roll out the tool better, improve its capabilities, improve their own maturity. So we have been helping some of our customers go through that journey. And I think largely it has been a pretty good journey to be able to look back.
Great. Thanks for that story. So in your experience, how has Kanban and the Kanban community evolved over the past 10 years, given that this is the 10th anniversary of Kanban University? And I think
I think the Kanban, the evolution of this body of knowledge has seen significant evolution through this entire decade, right? No doubt that David himself is a great thinker and a great storyteller. But there have been many people who have contributed to this whole body of knowledge, right? I remember when we first played the Get Kanban game, and so Russell's work with the Get Kanban game, to Mike's work and the evolution of Static, to really the KCP program. That was perhaps one of the best 5 days that I've ever sat through in one workshop. So the KCP program, to the ESP program, to the last about 4 years back when David and Alexis rolled out the fit for purpose work, Patrick's work around Flow, now KMM work. So I think while we might be a much smaller community in terms of when compared to a Scrum or a Safe community as such, but I think if I look at the amount of new intellectual property that is getting created in a single community, I think the Kanban community would beat all other communities hands down. I don't think there is any other community which is making such a significant, completely new thought process to the tables in terms of how organizations can improve their business agility. So beyond just those initial sets of practices and principles, I think today it's a very different body of knowledge that is out there for organizations to be able to really take benefit of. I think KMM obviously takes it to a very different level altogether. And I think KMM is still in its early years in terms of adoption and organizations being able to leverage that. So we'll know in a couple of years' time how the industry adapts to it. But for sure, as I said, the amount of new intellectual property that is created is absolutely stimulating.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Given that it's a 10-year journey, Digite has been a longtime partner of Ganban University, and I understand that Swift Ganban is also at its 10-year anniversary this year. So congratulations on that. You've also been very instrumental in the success of Ganban India, a conference that's been around for a number of years. How have you seen the Indian market respond to Ganban over the past 10 years?
Let me just break it up into two parts, because you made a reference to Swift Ganban completing its 10th year this year, and as a Swift Ganban product owner, it has been everything has been happening in the Ganban community pretty fast paced for us to keep up with it. We have made significant strides, significantly new capabilities that we have rolled out in the last 2 to 3 years. We have really pushed our velocity in terms of how fast we're now rolling out stuff. I'm really excited about something really cool that we plan to roll out as part of a 10th year anniversary release. So just a heads up, stay tuned for that. Coming back to the question around the Ganban India community, I think it is a niche community. It is a smaller community compared to the Scrum or the Safe community. But the good thing is we see a very focused group of people who are pretty passionate about the Ganban method, who keep attending the conference year after year. And I think our challenges are similar to many other organizations. People just think of Ganban as a Ganban board. India is no different. The good thing is that I think last year COVID gave us, unfortunately, with all the challenges that we all as individuals and families face, but COVID gave us an opportunity to be able to take our conference to the global audience with a global speakers, right? And we hope to be able to do that again this year. So I'm hoping that with all these changes in terms of being able to improve the profile of the community that we can reach out to, we are now able to see actually a lot more Ganban classes happening in India. I see those happening at a very, very regular frequency. I see our good friends in Innovation Roots regularly rolling out their own Ganban training classes. So that's a very good thing. And once again, it was great for Ganban University to be able to enable these classes online, because that really helps us to make these classes available globally to even a smaller number of people. So just that the regular cadence of doing these things, it creates traction and slowly the momentum picks up. So I think the Ganban community will grow. We have, as I said, hopefully more and more communities are now adopting Ganban in a lot more conscious way. The way the PSM community imbibe a lot of the Ganban thinking of flow and WIP and other things right into their body of knowledge speaks to the fact that what the Ganban community has been talking about is very much in there. I see that within the DevOps community in their rollout of the West Scrum model, and if you really look at how the West Scrum model has been structured, one out of the three boxes, one of the boxes is pretty much dedicated to the core principles of Ganban and Lean thinking. So I see we are pretty, I see a lot of opportunity where we will get more traction for people who may not have been looking at the Ganban method exclusively, but the fact that there's a strong overlap with other communities will pull them naturally into the Ganban India conferences and the Ganban community. So I hope that plays out. I see that as a very distinct possibility.
Right, great, thank you. What are you, I mean, obviously you're continuing to do a lot with Ganban now. What's sort of the highlights without spoiling us with your special surprise coming out in 10-year anniversary.
Let me keep it under the wrap. Otherwise, I'm going to be beaten up by your product marketing team for spilling the beans out there. But it would be something special. It would be something that others have not done. And I would say it would be something definitely pretty cutting edge. So just hang in there.
No, that's awesome. It's great. You've been around the community a long time. What do you value the most about the Kanban University community?
So I think very clearly the quality of conversations that we see within the Kanban community itself is pretty high quality, right? Occasionally, I think like in every other community, we sometimes do have some defensive discussions. But I would say 80-90% of the conversations that go on in the community, I've always give me an insight to be able to make my own thought process a little more clearer, a little more crisp, a little more, give me a slightly greater clarity of thought in terms of what I could do and how we could do it. I'm still looking for areas in the community where, for example, we see more discussion around some of the newer areas like the fit for purpose of body of knowledge itself. But I think as we pick up traction, I would see that. In general, I would think that the quality of the conversation within the Kanban community has been pretty high. I think also I would say that it always helps to have a community like that where you can reach out to in case of any question, clarification, without feeling the pressure that, you know, am I asking a very ignorant question? Am I asking a question that other other people might not be looking at nicely? So I think the openness of the community and the support that many people within the community actively give is a pretty great collaborative spirit out there.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you for the overall interview. Congratulations again, Sudhi.
Thanks, Todd. I really appreciate for the recognition that LKU has given to me personally and to Digiday as such.
Thanks.
Thanks. Take care. Bye-bye.